In this session, we'll study the biological importance of monosaccharides. Here, we'll study the biological importance of glucose, fructose, and ribose. As we studied in the previous session, monosaccharides are commonly called simple sugars, and they consist of a single polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone. Now, they are commonly called simple sugars because they are and the monomers because they cannot be hydrolyzed further. So chemically they are colorless crystalline solids which are soluble in water and insoluble in a non-polar solvent. Monosaccharides are made up of 3 to 7 carbon atoms. So the backbone of these monomers is made up of 3 to 7 carbon atoms. So for example, trioses, they are made up of 3 carbon atoms. Tetroses made up of 4. Pentose made up of 5 carbon atoms. Hexo sugars are made up of 6 carbon atoms. So like this, carbon atoms form, the carbon chains form the backbone of the monomers. And the classification is also dependent upon the number of carbon atoms they contain. And normally they end with suffix "-os". Now biological importance of glucose. In this section we will study the biological importance of glucose. Now glucose is one of the most important carbohydrate monomer, the molecule. And this plays a very important role in animals or plants or in organisms, because this molecule is known as the source of energy. So in humans, in other animals, and in plants, glucose is one of the most important nutrients for fueling the body. So this is a source of energy, and especially for nervous system, glucose is the only source of energy, because these cells, some of the cells like nerve cells, they cannot use other chemicals as a source of energy. Now glucose is broken down by glycolysis or Krebs cycle to produce ATPs. The glucose molecule is broken down during the process of glycolysis and Krebs cycle, and ATPs are produced. So these ATPs are used for various metabolic activities in the cell. And glucose is one of the monomer that forms a large number of oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. So glucose is actually part of many other oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. For example, maltose is made up of 2 glucose molecules. Lactose is made up of 1 glucose and 1 galactose. Sucrose is made up of 1 glucose and 1 fructose molecule, whereas the polysaccharides like cellulose, starch and glycogen, they are also made up of glucose molecules. So therefore, glucose as a monomer and glucose as a part of oligosaccharides and polysaccharides is very important in many metabolic activities and also in many other things related to the body. Now fructose is also having the same chemical formula, but structurally it is different from glucose. This is also a hexo sugar made up of 6 carbon atoms, and it is special because it is the sweetest carbohydrate. Plants actually produce fructose, and this fructose is used by the plants to attract insects and other animals. And it is an alternative for glucose during the metabolic activities. And biologically, the fructose can be used as an alternative to the glucose. It also yields the same number of ATPs if it undergoes the glycolysis and Krebs cycle. And it can also be used during glycation, wherein a lipid or protein is combined with a carbohydrate. So we know that the lipids and proteins combine with carbohydrates to produce glycoproteins and glycolipids. So in such cases, fructose molecule is also used. Then another important simple sugar is ribose. Now ribose is a pentose sugar which is made up of 5 carbon atoms. This molecule is important because it is part of the genetic material, that is DNA and RNA. So in case of RNA, ribose sugar is present, and in case of DNA, deoxyribose is present. And it is also component of nucleotides like NADH, NADPH and FADH. Now ribose molecule is also the component of adenosine triphosphate, which is the energy molecule or currency, which is commonly called as energy currency of living cells. So the ATP is also made up of ribose. Then D-ribose is used in the management of congestive heart failure. Clinically, the D-ribose is used, and it is also used to reduce cramps, pain and stiffness that occurs after exercise. So like this, the simple sugars like glucose, fructose and ribose have many importance and clinical applications.